It's funny to think how we had to fight and fight. How I wanted to be the secretary. No, no, no. You wanted to have the date tonight. I wanted to use a purse. My sister would have to come into the basement and see why we were all yelling at each other. But I remember the one thing we used to always do when we played house or office or dress up. One of us would suggest going to John's ice cream parlor, and our rehearsed plan would immediately begin. You would walk to the door, I'd walk over to the freezer. On the count of three, you would cough to muffle the sound of the Xbox door being opened so that my parents wouldn't hear it, and then we'd have access to as much chocolate ice cream as we could handle. Oh, it was the one time that we would never argue. Do you remember when we'd make tents from our comforters, making little homes out of our twin-sized beds? And we'd have pen lights and old calculators or flashlights for underneath our blankets. And it would be just enough light for us, but not enough for our parents to see, so that they thought we were actually sleeping. I remember I had always hogged the lights, the little calculator that lit up green that my sister gave me, or the yellow pen light that was running out of power anyway, or that little pocket video game with red numbers that lit up the screen. And I would always use the dowel rod from that bear's pennant that hung in the corner of my apple green bedroom to hold up my blanket. You'd have to make do with whatever else you could possibly find. God, I was a bratty kid. He should have stood up to me. When you called me to tell me that your father died, I wanted to tell you that I'd give you that bigger dowel rod or even that calculator. I heard you crying from that goddamn hollow plastic telephone, and I remembered how you'd always call over because you didn't want to stay in your own home with your own family. As if my family was much better. But now you're crying for him back when all your life you ran from him. And I wanted to bring him back for you, but I couldn't, and I was far away. So I did what I do best. Got drunk at a local bar. I found some friends who happened to be there, and they consoled me for your loss, something I couldn't even do for you. For my best friend. I know I got aggravated when you got hysterical over your wedding plans, when you couldn't find the right hurricane lamp covers for the centerpieces for the tables for the reception. Maybe they'll have them at the warehouse, Janet. Why don't you come with me? You're always the one that does the talking. You always know what you're talking about. When you couldn't get all 300 chunk guitars wrapped in tulle, then cellophane, then tied in gold foil with stars on it, then tied with the picks that you punched holes in, picks that say on them, Sheri and Warren. Janet, why are you the only person who showed up to help me? Why isn't anyone else here? Hey, I think you're cutting the tulle too big. None of your bridesmaids, none of those bridesmaids better get pregnant, you said, because the dresses wouldn't look right on them. And why is everyone complaining about 2-inch heels? And why isn't anyone interested in my wedding? I just want to tell you that I was interested in your wedding. Really. I was interested in the French door you got for the pantry in your new home. I wanted to make sure that the shine didn't come off the beads on that wedding dress that they sent to the cleaners. I wanted to see if that dress could fit me. Oh, probably not. You're so petite. And just think, you used to be taller than me when we were younger, playing Barbies on the pool table in the basement. I think I had a wedding dress for Barbie, the dream dress, and now I'll get to see that dress on you. The other day, my father said that he's glad to see one of his daughters get married without him having to foot the bill. And I thought you'd laugh at that. Well, maybe he won't have to foot the bill, but he'll still be losing a daughter. And we'll both be wiping the tears from